In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this smooth and splashy wave transition. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll animate some nice waves made out of shape layers, then add some splashy details. All right, let's jump right in. First of all, we create a new comp, name it Transition. Then we grab the pen tool from the toolbar and draw the first wave. We start just below the center of the right corner, then go to the left and further down, then down to the right, and we close the shape. Let's adjust the curves to create a nice wave. We switch between the selection and the convert vertex tool. No stroke, zero. And let's choose a bright blue as fill color. Okay. Let's open the contents property. Go into the path property and set a path keyframe at 15 frames. Awesome. Next, we go back to the beginning. Move the whole shape down, the two inner points to the left, and turn the convex part into a concave one, and the concave form into a convex form. All right, next we go to 30 frames. Again, move the inner two points to the left and up, and basically invert the shape form. The left part turns into the tip of the wave, the right part turns into the low part. Moving the two inner points back and forth gives the wave a direction. It kind of rolls from one side to the other. At 44 frames, it rolls to the right side again, but already above the screen. Awesome. Let's see. A bit rough, but the basic movement feels right. So let's open the graph editor, make sure Edit Speed Graph is selected, and let's adjust the speed of the animations. Let's try with creating these arcs. Not bad. The last move up is a bit fast, so let's slow it down. Let's speed this up here a little. I like it. So far. I think we should name the layer Wave. Then let's duplicate the layer and delay it 7 frames. And let's change the fill color into a very dark blue. We go to Layer in the top menu, Transform, and flip it horizontally. Okay, we need to adjust the shape. Let's move this point further down and adjust the curves a little bit. Let's move this part down as well to let the bright blue still be there in the background. Alright, then we duplicate the bottom shape again. Move it to the top and move it 15 frames to the right. Press U to see the keyframes. Let's again change the color into, I'd say, medium bright blue. Let's check it out. Not quite there yet. I think we need to slightly change the shape. Much better. We now duplicate the second shape, move it to the top, and 22 frames to the right. Press U to see this layer's keyframes as well. Let's see. Alright, some adjustments here as well. We keep the color this time, so we don't want the same color to overlap. Alright, this part here seems a bit fast. So let's go back into the graph editor and slow it down. We don't want the shapes to overlap, so let's do some adjustments once more. And even move this keyframe further to the right. By the way, if you like this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks very much. To add more detail to the shapes, let's select the top layer. Right-click on it and add a layer style. Inner shadow. We open the property and set the blend mode to normal. change the color into a slightly brighter one than the shape color. Set the distance to around 80, the size to 120. We add some noise. Let's actually brighten the color a bit. You might see the bright corners, which unfortunately means we need to move the paths further away from the screen. Then we copy the layer styles property and paste it to the other dark blue layer. And move the paths further away as well. Finally, we need to repeat that for the other two layers. Awesome. Next, we need an out animation. So we duplicate the bottom shape layer. Let's name it mask. Delete the layer style and set the shape color to white. And move the beginning to 37 frames. Let's add the set matte effect to one of the other layers. Search for it in the effects and presets window and add it. We take the matte from the mask layer and check invert matte. Copy it and paste it to the other three wave layers. We hide the layer and let's see. Awesome, transparent. We select the mask layer, press U to see the keyframes in the timeline. And let's speed this mask up by moving the keyframes further to the left. Awesome. This last bit is too fast, so let's slow it down. Much better. Now, let's add some splishy splashy details. With no layer selected, we grab the pen tool and draw a little drop shape. No stroke, white fill. Let's name the layer drop. To make the outline a bit more random, we add roughened edges. Leave all the settings as is, just set complexity to 1. We open the path property and set a path keyframe. Adjust the start point. Then two frames later, rotate it and move it to the right. Two more frames later, move it downwards. Move it like in a half circle. We adjust the endpoint. Let's see. Need to move it up here. And further down here. Awesome. We duplicate them and add some more splashes along the transition. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell to get notified when my next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye!